My name's Jake Clarkson, and I'm CTO at AMIGO Technology.
I am Nathan Burrill, and I'm the lead DevOps engineer at AMIGO, working directly with Jake. I was leading the decision on our choice to use MongoDB, and it's not disappointed. Now we've migrated to Atlas for our core data store.
So AMIGO starts with the question of how does a business change? Businesses often find themselves with, you know, millions of different options of what they could do at any given time, but often hamstrung by, you know, what's, you know, analysis paralysis, you know, what am I going to do? I'm overthinking things.
So the problem AMIGO solves is where you have a lack of resource or lack of buy-in from senior management to be able to enact changes.
So what makes AMIGO special is, and there are two key dimensions that I think that we excel in and differentiate ourselves. One is speed. So how quickly we can get something up in front of, you know, real customers. And the other is the amount of space you can access in the possible things you could do. So we, through AMIGO, really enable deeper exploration, deeper experiences, which could involve, you know, interaction with backends, you know, allowing people to think a bit bigger. And a challenge that we face is that people to break out of that box, you know, thinking what's possible. So we find that being able to offer demos really quickly to people is a real differentiator for us. And it's a nice benefit, really, of the ease of installation of our technology and our design goal, which we apply internally as well, of making it, you know, just focusing on what you want to do, focusing on the innovation as opposed to the sort of mechanics of how you're going to deliver that innovation. So AMIGO's tech stack is made up of Go. So we've been pretty early adopters of Go and have loved using that. We use Node.js quite extensively as well. We use Postgres for some components, and we use MongoDB pretty extensively for all the runtime data that we generate. That's our core platform for our tooling and the way that our team interact with our platform. We see React come in as well, and GraphQL for interaction with our databases. A large percentage of this is encoded in Terraform, which has been great, given us the speed to move and to not worry about you know, sort of brittle server configurations. And all of this is deployed onto Google Cloud Platform.
The VPC pairing with Google Cloud, so AMIGO is completely hosted on Google Cloud Platform. So the fact that A, we can host our MongoDB instances on Google Cloud Platform to minimize latency as much as possible, and the VPC pairing to the VPCs in which our apps are running is very beneficial, because obviously we get the security benefits of running in the VPC, and as I said, we get the reduced latency from running on the same cloud as the rest of our stack.
So some of the products we use on Google Cloud initially came for GKE, for the Kubernetes engine, but we also use things such as Cloud Run, Cloud Functions, a lot of the, maybe not every compute option, but most of them, Google Cloud Storage, CDN, Cloud SQL for how we host Postgres, and we also make extensive use of VPCs, again, mindful of security, and the peering. We use peering with MongoDB as well, which is deployed onto GCP. So that's been great.
The partnership with MongoDB has been really helpful. And so we've been using MongoDB Atlas for about 2 years now. So we started looking into Terraform as a way to both alleviate some of those problems, but also to be able to encode what the AMIGO platform looks like. As it came at around the same time, we were looking at MongoDB. Obviously, as soon as we started using MongoDB, we had a look at the MongoDB integration with Terraform, and it's been seamless, to be honest. Every feature we've needed is within the provider.
We need security, which is a key consideration for any business, but particularly for us. So that's been great for us. Various things here in Europe around GDPR and similar data requirements globally, such as, you know, not holding data for longer than is necessary. So the native time to live indexes have been great for us in Mongo, and really the global scalability.
It was one of the considerations we investigated before we settled on MongoDB as our runtime data store. So we, as a startup, we know the company is going to scale, or we hope the company is going to scale, so we know we're going to need to deal with more traffic than we currently do. At present, we manually scale our infrastructure, so our traffic is relatively predictable most of the time, but when we know there are events, so by the nature of the clients we work with, there are certain events in the year, such as Black Friday, in which case our clients will receive a lot more traffic, and therefore we will as well. So we'll preemptively scale for those scenarios.
The partnership with MongoDB has really helped the growth of AMIGO. You know, for me as a CTO, it's given me lots of benefits. So, with MongoDB, I now, it gives me peace of mind, really allows me and my team and wider business to focus on what our differentiators are, what we uniquely bring to the world, as opposed to, worrying about database management, the old days of having to, get up at 5 a.m. to run the maintenance, all that kind of stuff out the window, the latest security patches automatically applied with zero downtime. It's great. So the MongoDB for Startups program has been great for us as AMIGO. In a startup, resources can be, frankly, relatively scarce. So having those credits and having that freedom to explore and spin up, what are going to be, analogous, to our production deployments, not just spinning it up locally and see if it works. How's it going to scale? How's it going to deal with, some, high traffic scenarios? So having that there was great.
Yeah, the MongoDB for Startups program's been really handy. Initial point of contact was really helpful for answering the early questions. And he was also happy to put us directly in contact with technical support staff. So people who really understand and really get the nitty gritty of MongoDB. So we could ask as many in-depth engineering type questions as we needed to. And we got really helpful answers.
At AMIGO, we always want to hear from people that are struggling to enact change within their organization. Really want to help people and want to help you realize those ideas and to make sure that those ideas see the light of day, get them in front of real customers. Do please get in touch.